Hello everyone, very good evening. Welcome to Digitron Solutions. In today's video, I am going to demonstrate the working demo of the project, that is soil pH prediction, that is image processing based soil pH prediction using principal component analysis and RGB color based method. That is, the project is implemented, that is soil pH prediction is predicted using two separate methods. Initially, we will be performing principal component analysis to predict the soil pH from the input image provided, and later we will be applying color based method to predict the pH of the soil. The project is implemented in MATLAB. So let's see the working of the project. So I'll go in the MATLAB. I'll be using MATLAB 2018, but for this project even MATLAB 2015 onwards any MATLAB version will work. So I will go with the MATLAB file. So I'll run it. So this project also has an interface. So let it run. So this is the basic interface of the project, the determination of soil pH. So initially I have an option to browse the training data set. As I told you, the project is implemented using two methods, that is PCA method and color based method. It is like one is supervised learning method and one more is unsupervised learning method. Now a supervised learning method, that is PCA, is a method in which training is required, and in this color based method, that is unsupervised learning method, no training is required. So this training section is basically for our PCA method. So I'll say browse the training data set. So I'll go in the training data set, I'll select. So the training data set folder is selected and I'll say train the data set. So when I click on this, it will train our principal component analysis, means it will find out the principal components from our training data set and it will be saved. You might be knowing PCA means it will perform all covariance matrix calculation, perform Eigen vectors, Eigen values. So those all things will be done when I click on train. So this might take a while to train. Yes, training the data set is completed for our PCA. Even I have given an option to add a new data set. If you click on this, you can add new some soil images in the training set and retrain it. Okay, now I'll go directly with the testing. So I'll say browse test image. So go in the test section, I'll select a test image. Even I have given an option to crop it. So if you want, you can crop only the soil portion from the image. So here the image itself has entire crop section, sorry, soil section. So I'll select all of them, double click. So it will show the cropped image here. Then I'll say perform PCA based soil pH prediction. So I'll say PCA, perform PCA operation, and you can see the output has been displayed here. The PCA value for this particular soil is 7.92. Now we can even perform color based recognition. For this, no training is required. It is unsupervised learning method. So if I click this, even it has calculated. So it will be this particular method will be done using color based. So final output is 7.92. Even I have given an option to find the suitable crops based on the pH value of the soil, means which suitable crops are suitable on this particular soil. For that, we have used MySQL database. So I am using VAM server. My VAM server is running. Even I'll show you the database, localhost php myadmin. We have a database known as crop pH values. I'll show you that, then I'll click on that so that you will be clear about how the project is been implemented. Okay, we have a database known as crop detect, and if I click on that, we have one table which has all crop pH details. You can see these are all the crops. It has all the details like what is the minimum pH and maximum pH suitable for this crop, even temperature, humidity, everything. These are all the, I have some 26 crops. You can add more in your database. Now what I will do, I'll go here, I'll say find suitable crop matching to this particular pH value. So when I click on this, it will show in the command prompt. So it might take a while. You can see crop suitable are tobacco, cotton and mustard. These are the three crops matching in our database. So if you see the tobacco, the pH value minimum is 7.5, maximum is 8.5. So your 7.9 lies between this. Same way cotton also. So this is how the project is been implemented. I hope you understood the basic working of the project. I'll be stopping here. Yeah, thank you for watching. And if you are interested in the project, or you can go in the description section of this video and go to the link of our website and you can purchase it. If you are interested in some other projects, you can visit our website. Thank you for watching. Have a good day. Bye.